SMS spam detection using supervised machine learning. The contents of the project are, we'll talk about the introduction, what are spams and how it's growing with the improvement in technology. Then we'll talk about the rise of machine learning. Then we'll discuss the types of machine learning. We'll be discussing classifiers. And finally, in the last section, we'll be discussing different test case scenarios and their results. So SMS, short message service, has grown into a multi-billion dollar industry. Increase in unsolicited commercial advertisements being sent to mobile phones are increasing. It often uses the promise of free gifts like computer or gift cards, or product offers like cheap mortgages, credit cards, or debt relief services to get you to reveal personal information like your social security number or your credit card account number. Text message spam is illegal. You probably already know that your email provider uses a machine learning algorithm to identify spam. Google uses machine learning to identify and de-index web spam. And there are companies like Braintree, which are using machine learning in conjunction with other tools to stop credit card fraud. Scikit-learn is a Python module integrating a wide range of state-of-the-art machine learning algorithms for medium-scale, supervised and unsupervised problems. In this project, I have used Scikit-learn. So what are the types of machine learning? There are three types of machine learning. Supervised machine learning, which is like a predictive model, where we have a labeled data set. Then we have unsupervised learning, which is a descriptive model which has unlabeled data. And then finally we have a semi-supervised learning, which is mixture of labeled and unlabeled data. So what is supervised machine learning? Supervised learning consists of a target which is to be predicted from a given set of predictors. Using these set of variables, we generate a function that map inputs to desired outputs. The training process continues until the model achieves a desired level of accuracy on the training data. So how should we select a classifier? Scikit-learn has given an algorithm cheat sheet which can help us determine what classifiers we should use for our problem. So if we have a data sample less than 100K, we should use models like Naive Bayes or KNN. So we have used 5 to 6 different kinds of classifier on a data set for SMS spam detection. First kind of classifier that I've used is logistic regression. Logistic regression is a technique for classification. The word regression signifies how we fit a linear model in a feature space. So it's a misnomer. Involves a more probabilistic approach. It is used in scenarios where the outcome is discrete and not continuous. A linear decision boundary helps in improving the accuracy. It has several advantages, like it's quick to train and works very fast in classifying unknown records. The diagram is the log-it transform curve. Next is a support vector machine. It's a supervised learning technique and it finds its application in problem that requires classification. SVMs are very effective in high dimensional spaces, even when the number of samples are less than the number of dimensions. If the number of features are more than the number of samples, SVMs perform poorly. Naive Bayes classification. It's a probabilistic technique that is used in classification problems. It is used in scenarios where class assignment is not deterministic. It is robust to isolate noise samples and irrelevant attributes. It handles missing values by ignoring the sample during the probability estimate calculations. Decision tree. It's a non-parametric supervised learning technique which is used in classification and regression. It aims to create a model which can predict target variable's value by using simple rules inferred from the data. The cost of using the tree is log in number of data points used to train the tree. It performs well even if its assumptions are somewhat violated by the true model from which the data was generated. KNN is a non-parametric method used in classification and regression. The value of K largely depends upon the type of data. If we select a large value of k, noise would be reduced, but classification boundaries would become less distinct. Random forest. In random, each tree in the ensemble is built from a sample selected with replacement from the training set. Also, while splitting a node during the construction of the tree, the split that is chosen is no longer the best split among all the features. Instead, the split that is picked is the best split among a random subset of the features. As a result of the randomness, the bias of the forest usually slightly increases, but due to averaging, its variance also decreases, usually more than the compensating for the increase in bias, hence yielding an overall better model. Irrelevant attributes handles missing values by ignoring the sample during the probability estimate calculations. Stemming. In text processing, a stemming algorithm is a process of linguistic normalization in which the various forms of words are reduced to common form by removing a morphological affix. In this project, we have used Snowball. Given below is an example of a text, like a sentence where these are not the droids you're looking for. After stemming, we'll have some keywords like droid and look. Text process and vectorization. In our text processing, we aim to remove all the stop words and punctuation. That way we can make our data more clean. By doing this, we can ensure that the only data which is significant to the classifier stays. We use the TF-IDF vectorization method. In a large text corpus, some words will be present, like the A is, hence carrying very little meaningful information about the actual contents of the documents. If we feed the count data directly to the classifier, those very frequent terms would overpower the frequencies of rarer yet more interesting terms. In order to reweight the count features into floating point values suitable for usage by a classifier, it is very common to use TF-IDF transform. The dataset is a collection of 5574 English real and non-encoded messages tagged as ham for legit messages and spam for non-legit messages. So we have three test cases. In test case one, we'll do some initial data processing and we'll use that pre-processed text vector. In case two, we'll use with the pre-processed text vector also a function like stemming. In third case, we'll use pre-processed text vector stemming and also a message length feature into our curve, fit it into our curve and use different classifiers and see which gives us better results. The result of the first case shows clearly that naive bias is performing well with 0.98 accuracy, followed by SVC and random forest. The other classifiers are not performing that well. In second case with stemming, the naive bias has improved its performance from 0.984 to 0.985. There is improvement in random forest, but still it's less than the naive bias equation. In third case, when we also consider the message length, the improvement of random forest increases from 0.974 to 0.975, but still the leader is naive bias. So we can conclude that naive bias classifier is our friend when it comes to SMS spam filtering. Now we'll go on to the demo. So as we can see, I have imported all the libraries that are required, and once I have all my libraries, I read from my file the dataset and arrange the columns in useful form, and we do some text processing and vectorization of our message over here. Then we import different types of classifiers from scikit-learn library. We provide it, we tune it with like proper values, which gives us best results. this is our model where we'll train the classifier first with, we'll split the data set into half, where we'll train the classifier first, and then we'll get scores that we saw in our results. In the second case, we have stemmed the word, and we use the snowball stemmer. And again, we predicted the scores for our classifier with vectorized words and stemming. And in the final case, we also put the message length as one of our feature and train the classifier again. And we get the third result. Thank you so much.